This topic is about using minimum cuts to work out the maximum flow of a network. The maximal flow of a network can be checked by the fact that maximum flow equals minimum cut. Now, this is not something we're going to prove, but it does work. And in the previous tutorial, we looked at a different algorithm to find the maximum flow. But if you understand how to use minimum cuts, sometimes this method is much quicker, and it's also a good way of checking the other algorithm. The example shown here is the one we did in the previous session, and we found that the maximum flow was 1,050 litres per minute. We're going to learn about minimum cuts and then come back to this problem and see how we could have solved it using this method. So the first question is, what is a minimum cut, or in fact, what is a cut? Let's just recall that for a network, we have a source and a sink. So for this very simple network, the left is the source and the right is the sink. And now we talk about the region above the network and the region below the network. A cut simply is a line that runs through the network from above to below the network. So the red line is an example of a cut. Here's another one. And here's a third one, which is a little bit more complicated, and there's something a little bit different happening at this point here. The black lines with the arrowheads can represent any arc on the diagram. The first one has a cut which is flowing from above to below, and that's what we're looking for, and we're going to count the weight of that arc in our determination of for minimum cut. But if the direction of our cut is coming from below to above, we do not count it. The rule is that we always cut from top to bottom, and in the last example I gave, we're going to count the first cut through that line with a tick mark there. We're not going to count the cut through this arc because we've come from below the arc to above the arc. Now, to understand that, imagine that that arc has been laid horizontally pointing from left to right, and I'm sure you'll agree that that red line is coming from below. The next one down, we do count because the red line or the cut is coming from above. So let's look at a really simple example. And to help this make sense, let's use the algorithm we learnt in the previous tutorial. And then we'll compare methods. So looking at the top pathway, the smallest number is a 3. So I subtract 3 from all numbers. And I have 2 unused capacity over on the right. Let's look at the pathway through the middle. The smallest number is 2. Subtract 2 from all of these numbers, and I have 2 units of unused capacity on the left. And one final pathway down the bottom. Smallest number is 2. Subtract that. And you can see that everywhere on this network, we have used all capacity. So what was the maximum flow? If I look at the source, I have 2 arcs coming from the source node with capacities 3 and 4. 3 plus 4 is 7, so the maximum flow must be 7. Alright, so what if we were to use the idea of minimum cuts? Well, first of all, remember that you need to work from top to bottom. My first cut was 7. Remember, you're looking for the minimum cut, so keep making as many cuts as you feel you need to until you're confident you've found the smallest value for your cut. On the other side, I have a 5 and a 2, which is a 7. All right, let's see if I can find something smaller. Down through the middle, 3 plus 2 plus 2 is 7. And what about this one? 3 plus 2 plus 2 is also 7. So you can possibly add a couple of others, but it really does look like the minimum cut here is 7, and Indeed, that's what we expected for this example. Here's another one. Let's jump straight in and look at minimum cuts. Starting on the side of the source, 8 plus 3 is 11. In the middle area, working from top to bottom, 2 plus 4 plus 2 is 8. A little bit further along, 2 plus 4 plus 3 is 9. And on the other end, I've got a 4 plus 3 equals 7. So I'm thinking maybe the minimum cut is 7, but it's always worth having another look. And over here, we have a 4 plus 2, which is a 6. But look, we also have a 2 plus a 3, which is a 5. And we can't do any better than that. The minimum cut, and therefore the maximum flow, is 5 units. Now let's go right back to the example we started with. Why don't you pause the video for a moment and perhaps take a screenshot and see if you can work out the maximum flow using the idea of minimum cuts. Okay, so you can probably add a couple of extra cuts here, but I can't see any way of finding a smaller value, and the number we expected was 1,050 litres per minute. So the idea of minimum cuts can be very useful. You can use it to check the previous algorithm we learnt, or you can jump straight in and try and find the maximum flow for a network by determining the minimum cut. Be careful you're always working from above the network to below the network. In other words, make your cuts from top to bottom. Make sure you don't count the weight of any arc if you happen to double back and work from below to above. But most cuts will be fairly straightforward. The trick is to make sure that you make enough cuts to find what really is the minimum cut, and then you can be confident you're getting the correct answers.